Bad kitty. Side. Shift Q. Up. Side. Side. Shifty. Up. So, oh no, she took one of our grappling hooks. Ugh. Just put a little makeup on.
And be Bruce Wayne tonight.
Oh, that's a much harder fight.
Don't let tombstones be your family legacy.
For too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. Now, Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is Carmine Falcone. Thank you for welcoming me into your home. You're a respectable man, I hear.
Bruce Wayne.
I know who you are. The guy who's gonna sell me his house.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, you were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
It's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to Batman, a Telltale series here on Touchy Elf. I am Abigail, and I'm still working out the audio problems. But anyways, I increased the size of the subtitle, so that should help. And I'm playing with headphones, which will prevent the game from echoing. So, anyways, just in case if you do have to turn up the volume a lot for the to hear the characters, I will not be speaking during cutscenes or fighting scenes. The only time I will be talking is during these moments where I can move around. So that being said, let me put my microphone back down. There we go. Okay. So let's see what is there to be seen. Let's start by looking at, nope, we can't look over there. Let's look at this graffiti. Looks like Bruce doesn't have any thoughts on it. Recent newspaper, what does it have to say? Bruce Wayne associates with mob boss. Okay. Oh, and here we go. I forgot to look at the side. Sorry about that. Homeless person will go ahead and give change because we're loaded. We can give people money.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. I hope you get the help that you need. I really do hope that you get the help that you need. Okay, Burning Barrel, let's go take a look at it. Must be a very crisp and cool morning if you're warming yourself already. Speaking of which, Bruce, I see that Catwoman's marks are still on your chin. A little bit of makeup will cover that right up. Ronnie, let me meet you at the statue.
There's the statue, but no Oz.
Well, he just said that he's running late. Smoking man, we can go talk to him. Shopping cart. Anything over here that we can look at? More graffiti? Here's a plaque. Let's go ahead and have a look at it. I won't be able to read it. I'll try to read it. Cobblepot Park. When it was established.
Isn't what it used to be.
Yep, that's for sure. Wait, that actually looks like the penguin. That looks like the penguin. It's the penguin from Scooby-Doo, guys. It really is. Oh, look, more graffiti. Much to say about it. Let's, should we talk to him? Sure, why not?
Hey.
Beat it.
Okay. I just want to say hi. Okay. Hello, Penguin. You look lovely today. What a weird thing to say.
Wallet cash. But this goes through you.
Hey, you heard him, man. The hell are you waiting for?
You're making a mistake.
You already made one coming here. Next one kills you.
End him.
Gentlemen!
Oz.
Keep walking, all right?
This don't concern you, twerp!
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do.
The moment! Come here! You think that'll do?
Oops.
Stay down! Used to be a nice place. No lives like you don't belong.
Ow. Ow.
This is my park. Mine. You hear that?
I really like your coat, Oz.
Oh, hey, Bruce. You've got a little, yeah, good as new. That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts a system like a dash of adrenaline, eh? Besides, someone needed to deal with the rubber situation here.
Well, thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah, it's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
No, that wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
Well, those were better days.
That they were. Yeah. Thought we'd grow up to be kings, I did. Both of us. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, you did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round the world vacations, unlimited potential.
I'm sorry, Oz. No one should have to go through that.
Thanks, Bruce. But we are not the only ones suffering. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily... Oh. Wish I could have punched that grin in the back of his throat.
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. Never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Falcone made a stack of cash in corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement.
Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, no? A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. When my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
That's a battle you won't win, Oz.
No. Oh, I've learned a thing or three since we were kids. I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you.
Thanks.
When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
I'm already on the right side. I like to think. Press conference. Car waiting for you. That's Arkham Asylum? It looks so pretty! Well, definitely needs a new coat of paint. Fashionably late as always. That's a really nice car. It reminds me
this
of another
way,
car.
Here, right here. This way.
Bruce.
Morning, everyone. Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars? I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. But we didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. And worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, this sizable contribution from this man here. We break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
For those with mental health issues, there are no cuts or scrapes. Their ailments are often invisible, but inside, they're suffering. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, we create a new face for Gotham.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
We should tear down the walls and erase it from the map. I don't want us lingering on past mistakes. I want us to focus on Gotham's future. All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remark of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You even shook his hand.
Well, I think Mr. Falcone is a voter just like anyone else in this city. He came to learn about Harvey Dent, your next mayor. Next question.
Please, keep your questions on topic, people. We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
I don't comment on rumors. Why don't we just stick to real journalism here?
Mr. Wayne! Mr. Wayne! Is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What are you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
All right, this press conference is over.
Mr. Wayne! Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What are you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage controls my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
I understand. You're just doing your job, Lieutenant.
Trying to. It's hard to be a cop in this city. Every battle's uphill, in the rain, with skates on.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
Who authorized this?
I know you and the DA are buddy-buddy, but this one came from the top. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Okay, so you just do whatever Mayor Hill says.
Hill and I, we have a vested interest to keep things professional. For Gotham's sake. Doesn't mean I like the words whistling through his windpipes. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's chopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Stay back!
Take whatever you want!
You don't have to do this.
Bruce? I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
This is the second time you've shown up uninvited.
Well, it's difficult to book a meeting with you.
Well, I enjoy my privacy.
Enjoyed. Past tense. Sorry, but if the press has their way, you're not gonna have any for a while. Listen, Bruce, a scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention. Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access.
What's your angle?
Not all reporters just want a headline. Some of us are old-fashioned. I still want the truth. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay. Flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family. After me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran. Not every day you get to go after a Wayne.
Well, first guess, nosy reporters.
The public's fascinated with you, Mr. Wayne. A scandal like this, it's a reporter's dream. By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
This story about my family is exactly that. A story. It's a work of fiction all the way through.
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Rail.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke.
A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family? We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this on the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
Cafe Teresa, 5:23 p.m.
The warrant? What the hell's going on? Wait, does this have to do with what the reporters were talking about this morning? That press conference turned into a bloodbath.
Yeah, someone's coming after me.
Let's avoid making another scene, shall we? The press is already up my ass as it is. Mayor Hill authorized this?
Yeah, then the cops raid my house, taking everything related to Wayne Enterprises. Computers, hard drives, files.
Oh, son of a bitch.
You're the goddamn DA, Harvey.
I didn't know about this, I swear. Hill totally blindsided me on this one. God damn it.
Okay, I believe you, Harvey. Mayor Hill's trying to screw us both over with this move.
And then he's made two enemies. I just don't get it. Why would Hill stick his neck out over this? Just to tangle you up in some frivolous investigation? It just doesn't make sense. I mean, what could he possibly hope to accomplish other than a few cheap headlines?
That is exactly what I intend to find out.
Easy, Bruce. Oh, God, what a mess. Bruce, I wish I could just make this go away, but I'm not sure if I can. If I get in the way of this investigation, Hill would be able to spin it as a conflict of interest. And that wouldn't be good for either of us. It would jeopardize the entire campaign.
You should probably distance yourself from me.
What? No. No, I can't do that.
Well, you may have to.
Don't say that. You...
There you are.
Hey, you.
Sorry. I got a habit of being late.
No, no. Just glad you made it.
You didn't tell me you were bringing a friend to dinner.
This is Selina.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
Just election nonsense.
I'm Bruce Wayne.
So you are.
Pleasure to meet you, Miss...
Kyle. It's a strong grip you've got there. Don't worry. I'm not gonna fall.
Oh, right. Sorry.
Selina's new to town. I've been showing her around Gotham, introducing her to people.
You're an excellent tour guide, Harv.
Well, if I lose the election, I guess I can drive one of those double-decker tour buses around town.
Meet anyone interesting?
Not really. They haven't all been as welcoming as Harv. I was mugged. I'm just angry I let that masked freak get away with all my stuff.
I still can't believe I let you walk home alone. I should have called you a car.
Did you at least get a look at the guy?
Good enough to make an ID.
Well, I'll get Gordon down to GCPD to work on a lineup. That's probably long gone by now, whatever that idiot took.
I hope not. These were important materials.
Ooh, sensitive?
Very. I don't know how I'm gonna explain this to my client. When things like this happen in my line of work, people tend to overreact.
I'm sure your clients will understand.
I doubt it. In my business, people aren't very forgiving. At least I'm not the only one who's taken a beating. That press conference? Oof.
We've got it under control.
Do you?
I'll handle it. Someone at my office has to know what's going on. Excuse me a moment. Hey, it's Harvey.
Nice to meet the real you.
likewise.
This explains a lot, actually. How you can afford the fancy armor, the toys. Wouldn't Harvey be surprised? Not to mention everyone in this cafe.
You going to play nice this time?
Well, that depends on you. Don't worry. I'm not gonna expose you. Yet. I'm curious about something, though. I do what I do for money, but you're... Bruce Wayne. What's your excuse? I have to. But you... Why take the risk?
I think you know enough already. The rest is my secret.
And here I was thinking we were starting to get somewhere. How disappointing. You have something that belongs to me. I want it back. This is awkward for me. I'm used to robbing people, not the one being robbed.
Who hired you to break into the mayor's office?
My clients prefer to remain confidential. They don't know who I am, I don't know who they are.
But you know who I am.
These people I'm working for, they don't screw around. If I fail to deliver that drive, it's gonna cost a lot more than money.
Well, looks like you've made your bed.
No, we've made this bed, and I'm not gonna lie in it alone. You owe me. If they don't get what they want, there will be consequences. I don't like consequences. In fact, I spend most of my time avoiding them.
Oh, you don't need my help. You seem pretty capable of handling this yourself.
Oh, I intend to. Just give me back the drive and I'll be on my merry little way.
Yeah, I'd rather not.
Listen, I don't have a lot of time. My employer is expecting me to drop it off.
Where?
Just give it back.
The address, now.
No, give me the drive.
You're just going to have to trust me.
I don't do trust. I guess I'm screwed either way. My contact, he'll be expecting a cat, not a bat.
When are you supposed to meet him?
15 minutes ago. Better hurry.
Everything okay here?
You tell me.
I have my people working on it. We're gonna straighten everything out.
I feel better already. Sorry, but I've got to run.
So soon? Aren't you gonna stay for a drink?
Yeah, Bruce. Stay for a drink?
I'd love to, but I've got another appointment and I really don't want to be late for it.
Oh, all right then. Don't forget to change into your suit.
Alfred, I'm at the warehouse. No sign of Catwoman's contact. It's quiet.
The sound of an ambush. Stay on guard.
Okay then, let's see what's here to be seen. I'll just press W to open this door up.
This wasn't a handoff. It was a massacre.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Oh, good Lord. Who could have done such a thing?
That's what I'm gonna find out.
Gordon, Eastside Docks, Warehouse 133.
Okay, so I think I will go ahead and explain some of my decisions and actions right now because I'm going to be ending this episode here. Excuse me. So, I do think that we may still be able to save Oz if we really work at it. And I know that I really wasn't the kindest to Catwoman. But the thing is that I don't trust her. And I'm not doing this job because I like her or because I want her to trust me. I'm doing it because I want to know what she knows. I want that information. If someone's attacking me and my family, I want to know why and to what purpose. So that's pretty much my angle on that. So let me see here. Also, I apologize if I was a bit sharp with her. Oh my goodness, I'm sorry. But that's kind of how it goes. I also think that was a little too sharp with Gordon. But it really couldn't be helped. I mean, yeah, there really wasn't anything that we could do. As for the picture being knocked over, I'm pretty sure it was an accident. And I will be having a separate video on what I think about Miss Vale and her journalistic inquiries and explain what due diligence is. It'll be a fun video and it'll be on about half an hour after this video becomes live. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. I am Abigail, and I hope to see you next week for another episode of Batman, A Telltale Series. So, until then, stay in touch. Bye!